Hi folks, I'm Andrew. You're watching Prehistoric Australia. Welcome back to part three of my five-part series exploring what the world was like during the age of dinosaurs, specifically in Australia's inland seas. I recommend that you watch my episodes about the first and second inland seas so you know where the Eromanga Sea came from. In today's episode, part three, we get to talk about the juicy stuff, the fossils, specifically the gigantic marine reptiles which once dominated the Third Inland Sea. The Third Inland Sea of 115 million years ago was the largest inland sea of Cretaceous Australia. The sea level was so high that it nearly covered a quarter of Australia, creating a series of islands. Unlike the other inland seas, this third sea was not completely enclosed, and there were openings to the open ocean on multiple sides of Australia. These openings could be found to the north, northeast, southeast, and southwest of the Third Inland Sea. Finally, this is the inland sea that features plenty of rocks that have risen to the surface for paleontologists to study. The thick sediment layer forms the most extensive and fossil-rich marine rocks of the Australian inland seas. Marine sediments from this time come from the Woolloombilla Formation in Queensland, the Oodnadatta Formation in South Australia, and the Elinga Formation in Western Australia. The climate of the Eromanga Sea, particularly to the south, was a bit colder on average, with seasonally fluctuating temperatures. Evidence of this drop in temperature comes from mineral structures known as glendonites that have been discovered in South Australia. These glendonites date back to the early Cretaceous period and only form when temperatures are below 4 degrees Celsius and soils are exposed to seasonal freezing and thawing. So, glendonites indicate that the ground was sometimes frozen in winter. Meanwhile, dropstones have also been discovered in South Australia. Dropstones are literally pebbles that have been dropped in the water by melting sea ice. Dropstones indicate that the water currents of the Eromanga Sea carried winter ice. Overall, dropstones and glendonites tell the story of a cooler climate during the Third Inland Sea. Meanwhile, the fossil evidence tells the story of a marine ecosystem just teeming in life. At the bottom of the food chain were plankton. In turn, plankton were fed upon by slightly bigger creatures. Filter feeders included bivalves, which were so numerous they would have formed carpets on the seafloor. Other filter feeders and small predators included fish, gastropods, sea lilies, tusk shells, ammonites, belemnites, sea urchins, sea stars, crayfish, and razor shells. Yeah, to say these seas were teeming with marine life would be an understatement. Marine reptiles occupied the top of the food chain, the superstars of the inland seas. Only two groups, turtles and crocodiles, survived until the present day. But there were three other groups of marine reptiles that dominated the oceans during the age of dinosaurs: the plesiosaurs, pliosaurs, and ichthyosaurs. The most common group were the plesiosaurs. Plesiosaurs typically have medium to long necks, small heads, stout bodies, and four flippers for locomotion. Pliosaurs such as Kronosaurus queenslandicus were the largest predators on Earth at that time. Pliosaurs had short necks, large heads, powerful, robust bodies, and four flippers for locomotion. Kronosaurus had very large, slightly curved teeth. Each of these daggers measured up to 25 centimeters long. The bones of turtles, plesiosaurs, and fish have also been found in the gut contents of Kronosaurus. Kronosaurus was undoubtedly the apex predator of the Eromanga Sea. In fact, it was so successful that it dominated for 15 million years, from 115 to 100 million years ago, the time of the fifth and final inland sea. So, soon the third inland sea would disappear, but Kronosaurus would continue to rule the fourth inland sea. At the height of its sea levels, the largest inland sea Australia has ever known only lasted for about 2 million years. By 113 million years ago, the third inland sea had retreated slightly as global sea levels fell. 8 million years later, the fourth inland sea rose in its place. Join us next time for part four, where you will learn about the fourth inland sea. Thank you.